Hi friends, today we are going to talk about how important designing of environment is in living the kind of life that we want to live. How to design life on our own terms. But what is this? Ye kya rakha hai background mein? We can't shoot it this way, just cut it off. We need something better. I mean, look at this background. Just cut it off. This is much better. So my friends, we meet again. Now today we're going to talk about if you want to live a happy life, what is the importance of environment in living life on our own terms or to live a happy life? If you look at it, a happy life is a summation of good, happy experiences. And for every experience, one of the major important ingredients of an experience is the environment in which we are experiencing life. Now, environment is constitutes of three elements, and I'm going to give you three tips on how you can enhance your environment to enhance your experience and thereby live life on your own terms. Variable number one is the physical setting that you are in. So if you go to a five-star hotel and if you have dinner there, naturally you're going to enjoy it because the physical setting around is very, very good. So always make it a matter of priority to choose the physical setting at every time and any time it is possible. Now, it may not always be possible to choose the physical setting, but sometimes you can. The college that you go to, the office that you work in, you can make a conscious choice to see if you can choose a good physical setting where the environment is favorable towards you having a happy experience. Many a times we give other things more important thing. The environment is not that important, or we just leave it to chance. Now, you should make it a conscious choice to choose the physical environment to have that experience. Number two, one of the major importance of the environment is the people that we interact with. The friends you have, the teachers you have, the colleagues you have, and therefore, because people have an important impact on the kind of experience that we have. If you have bad customers and if you deal with them every day, naturally your life is not going to be good. If you have friends whose company is not very good, who are dampening your spirits every time, you are not going to have a good life. So always make it a point to choose the people that you interact with. And the third and the most important element of an environment is your mental setup, your mental environment. So many a times you may not be in a position to choose your physical setting. Many a times you may not be in a position to choose the kind of people that you interact with. At such times, your mental setup can help you. Your mental environment can help you. So if you have a learning attitude, you can sail through even a bad environment or sometimes people whom you don't like very much. And what is the best way to set up a mental environment is read books, be in an environment that creates your own mental world, and in that own mental world you create your own mental environment which becomes more overpowering than the physical environment that you have in. So if you have this, even a bland Lara, he doesn't get to play on a good cricket field and doesn't have a good coach, can still learn cricket even with a piece of log of wood if he has a good mental environment and a learning attitude. So always choose a physical setting where you can learn something from. Always choose the right people who you can interact with, and always keep your mental environment fertile and positive by reading good books, by having good thoughts. Now, this is a matter of lifestyle change. Slowly and slowly, you will come to a place where you can choose a physical setting, where you can choose the people that you interact with. So when you are getting into a job, just don't look at the salary package. Just don't look at which company you are looking for. Do some research and find out what kind of people you are going to be work with. What is the culture over there? Where do they have the office? What are the opportunities you are going to get to learn over there? So learning environment, kind of people you interact with when you are doing business. Don't only see what the price the customer is ready to pay. What kind of customer is he? What are his values? What is his history? Do you love to be in touch with the kind of people that your customer is? So do your values match with the values of your customer? These are the things that we see into. Slowly and steadily, you will be designing your life in such a way that most of the times you are in environments which favor the kind of life that you want to live. So life doesn't happen by default or fate. Life happens by design. Follow these tips and you will very soon be living the kind of life that you want to live. That's it for today. Keep learning, keep contributing, keep on enjoying your uniqueness and celebrating your uniqueness, and have fun in life. Thank you so much. See you next time.